Welcome to AVTECH's video demonstration, How to Create Alerts in Device ManageR, Start to Finish. This demonstration will walk you through five steps to create the most common type of alert, an email or email to SMS notification. You'll see how to set up your mail server, contacts, actions, action notification list, and alert. The most common type of alert to use in Device ManageR is an email or email to SMS message. In order to send email from Device ManageR, you must first configure your mail server. Begin by opening Device ManageR in your browser at localhost colon 8080 if you're working from Device ManageR's host system. Otherwise, if you're working from a different computer on your network, you may enter the IP address of Device ManageR's host system, colon 8080, in your browser's address bar. To begin entering your mail server, first select Settings in the navigation bar to the left. Then select SMTP Email from the Settings menu. In the SMTP Email page under Primary Mail Server, enter your mail server IP or DNS name. In our example, we're entering mail.example.com. In port number, you may leave the default 25, a commonly used port, or enter the port that your mail server uses. In our example, we're leaving the default. Typically, you may leave SMTP timeout at the default 15 seconds, as we have here. If your mail server uses SSL or TLS encryption, check the appropriate box. Otherwise, leave those boxes blank. In our example, we're leaving them empty. In From Email Address, enter the email address you want alert notifications to come from. In our example, we're entering sender@example.com. If your mail server requires login credentials, enter the username and password for the from address. Otherwise, leave those fields blank. In our example, they're required. If you wish, you may enter an address in test email recipient. This address will receive a test email if you choose to send one later in the process. In our example, we're entering recipient@example.com. Then select Save Settings. Once you've saved your mail server information, you may wish to select Send Test Email to make sure you configured your settings correctly. This email will go to your test email recipient. After you've set up and successfully tested your mail server, the next step is to enter the contacts that your notifications will go to. You may send alerts from Device ManageR as an email to a contact's email address or as a text message to their mobile phone's email to SMS address. To add a contact to Device ManageR, first select Alerts Tasks in the navigation bar to the left of your screen. Next, select Contacts from the Alerts Tasks menu. Then select Add to open the Add New Contact window. Enter a name for the contact in the Name field. In our example, we're entering IT Manager's Work Email. In Description, an optional field, you may enter any notes you feel would be helpful to explain the contact. In Email Address, enter the contact's email or email to SMS address. In our example, we're entering itmanager@example.com. Then select Save. Your contact will now appear in your contacts list. You may repeat this process to add as many contacts as you wish. Here you can see we've added a total of 4 contacts. Once you've saved a contact, it's a good idea to return to it in order to send a test email. To do so, highlight your contact in the contacts list. Select Edit at the bottom of the page, and then select Send Test Email. Repeat this for all of your contacts. Once you've saved and tested all of your contacts, the next step is to associate them with actions. There are a variety of actions you can execute through Device ManageR. We're going to choose the default and most commonly used type, sending an email or email to SMS message. To set up an action, select Actions in the Alerts Tasks menu in the navigation bar to the left. Then select Add to open the Add New Action window. Enter a name for the action in Name. Our example is called Email IT Manager. In Description, an optional field, you may enter any notes you feel would be helpful to explain the action. In Action Type, select the action you wish to execute from the drop-down list. In this example, we'll leave the default action type, Send Email to Configured Contact. In Contact, select one of your contacts from the drop-down menu. In our example, we're selecting IT Manager's Work Email. In If Not Successful, Retry This Action, you may leave the default 0 or enter a higher number. In our example, we've left the default. Then select Save to save the action. Your action will now appear in your actions list. You may repeat this process to add as many actions as you wish. Here you can see we've added a total of 4 email actions, one for each of our 4 contacts. Once you've saved an action, it's a good idea to return to it in order to send a test email. To do so, highlight your action in the Actions list, select Edit at the bottom of the page, and then select Test. Repeat this for all of your actions. Once you've saved and tested all of your actions, the next step is to put them in an Action Notification list. Your Action Notification list may include one or many actions. Grouping actions together in an action notification list allows you to execute multiple actions in response to one alert condition. In this example, we'll group the email actions we made in the previous step in order to notify multiple contacts when an alert occurs. To create an action notification list, first select Action Notification Lists from the Alerts Tasks menu in the navigation bar to the left. Then select Add to open the Add New Action Notification List window. Enter a name for your list in the Name field. In our example, we're calling our list Notify IT Staff. In Description, an optional field, you may enter any notes you feel may be helpful to explain the list. Then select Add again to open the Add Action Notification List Item window. In Alert Action, select the action you want executed when the alert condition is triggered. In this example, we're selecting our Email IT Manager action. And start the action after X seconds, you may leave the default 0 to have the action begin immediately after the trigger, or enter a higher number of seconds to delay the start of the action. We've left the default of 0 in our example. In Repeat the action every X seconds, you may leave the default 60, or enter another value to control how frequently the action repeats. In our example, we've entered 300 in order to send emails at 5-minute intervals. In Perform the action, you may leave the default continuously or cap the number of times the action is performed by selecting a maximum of X times. You may leave the default of 1 or enter a higher value. In our example, we've capped the repetitions at 3. In Clear action, you may select an action if you want it performed when the alert condition clears. In this case, we are selecting our Email IT Manager action so that the contact receives a clear notification. Select Save to save your action notification list item and return to the Add New Action Notification List window. To add more items to your list, select Add again and repeat these steps. You may add as many items to your list as you wish. In our example, we've gathered the 4 email notification actions we set up earlier in the Notify IT Staff list. When you're ready to save your action notification list, select Save. Your list will now appear in your action notification page. Once you've saved your action notification list, the final step is to associate it with an alert. To create an alert in Device Manager, first select Alerts in the Alerts Tasks menu in the navigation bar to the left. Then select Add to open the Add New Alert window. Enter a name for your alert in the Name field. Our example is called Data Center Temperature Greater Than 80 Degrees Fahrenheit. In Description, an optional field, you may enter any notes you feel may be helpful to explain the alert. In Device, select your Room Alert from the drop-down list. We're choosing the Room Alert 32E in our data center. In Alarm When, you'll see a drop-down list with all of the unit's individual sensors. Select the specific sensor you wish to alert on. In our example, we're choosing Internal Sensor Temperature Fahrenheit. In Is, set the threshold for that sensor. The fields that appear here depend on the type of sensor you've chosen. In our example, we have a Comparison and Value field. First, select from the Comparison drop-down list. In our example, we're choosing greater than. Then, in value, enter the number that makes sense for the scale you're using. In our example, we're measuring temperature in Fahrenheit, so we're going to enter 80 degrees Fahrenheit. In alarm if item is unavailable for X scans, you may leave the default 4 scans or enter another value. You may also disable this feature if you wish by unchecking the checkbox. In our example, we're leaving the default. In Action Notification List, select a list from the drop-down menu. Here we're choosing the Notify IT Staff Action Notification List that we assembled in the previous step. In our example alert, 4 contacts from an IT department will be notified by email or email to SMS when the temperature in their data center climbs above 80 degrees Fahrenheit. When you finish configuring your alert, select Save. Your alert will now appear in your alerts list. You may repeat this process to create more alerts. You may also use the same action notification list over and over again for different alerts, as we have here. For any additional information, please feel free to contact us by email at sales@avtech.com or support@avtech.com or through live chat on our website, avtech.com. Thank you.